And we continue at 2:07 in the afternoon. Talk Radio 790 KABC, the John Phillips Show, broadcasting live from the Morongo Casino Resort and Spa Living Room Studios, where, Randy, you're always a winner. Maybe not when it comes to money, but there's the buffet. Mr. Randy Wang's at the sports desk in Culver City.
John, I just hit the publish button on the podcast of the 1 o'clock hour. So in case you missed John's interview with LA County District Attorney candidate, Deputy District Attorney Eric Saddahl, you can now download that on the KABC app, KABC AM. Search for it on the Apple App Store or the Android Store. And what's great about a podcast is you can listen to it whether your pants are down.
Caught me with my pants down.
Or your pants are up.
My pants are now up.
Okay, I don't know in what context we'll use those drops, but I'm sure something will come up.
Someone emailed asking for them, so I thought I'd cut them up. But it's been a great week for callers turning their comments into drops.
Oakland, on the other hand, my God, you got to be nuts to live there.
Speaking of which, it's time for us to talk about the city of Oakland.
You mean this city?
Oakland, I love you, but you don't love me.
Yes, that one.
You mean this one?
Oh, my God. They melted the basketball court.
That's the Oakland.
This one?
It's Wild Wild West out here.
Nail Meathead. And we're talking about Oakland because it's time for the mayor of Oakland. Sheng Thao is her name, correct?
That's right. She's 38, so she's the same age as me, and she thought she could be mayor of the city of Oakland.
And it was time for her to deliver the State of the City address, given all the problems that they're facing in Oakland.
It was done at the Oakland City Council meeting yesterday. All of the Bay Area news stations took this thing live on their YouTube channel. So I was actually watching it while it was happening. And I don't know why they do this, but the mayor chose to be introduced by some youth group that was talking about how vibrant Oakland is. And Sheng Thao wanted to give a shout out to those youths in the most inauthentic way possible.
All right. Well, thank you so much to our young people, our young leaders of tomorrow that helped join us today. I'm so happy that you all are with us today. You are all our future. And truly, they give us so much hope, don't they? Yes, they do. Yes, they do.
Maybe you know, she thought there would be an applause there.
Newsom doesn't like to give the State of the State addresses because he's dyslexic and can't read a prompter. So he finds ways to avoid doing it. If I was the mayor of Oakland and I had to give a State of the City address, I wouldn't even give a speech either. I'd just take a dumpster and light it on fire and just put that right in the center of the room.
Oh my God, they melted the basketball court.
I think she really thought that she was going to get applause for this inauthentic line about the kids are our future. And then she had to play it off, and it did not go well.
All right. Well, thank you so much to our young people, our young leaders of tomorrow that helped join us today. I'm so happy that you all are with us today. You are all our future. And truly, they give us so much hope, don't they? Yes, they do. Yes, they do.
She is in Oakland. She is uniquely a terrible elected official.
She's special, as they say.
And, you know, I always wonder, like, you know, when Oakland Mayor Sheng Thao, when she decided to run for city council and then run for mayor, I wonder who her inspirations were. And I think her inspiration to become a political official was then Assemblyman, now Attorney General Rob Bonta, because she's got buckets full of cliches, too.
Here in Oakland, we know that coming together is how we will tackle our collective challenges. That coming together is how we will solve them.
Well, if that's what she picked up from Rob Bonta, that would explain a lot.
Every type of leadership is about meeting the moment and rising to the occasion. And this is what's required. And so we're stepping up and getting it done.
John, can you explain to the audience back in the 90s, Bill Clinton captured the country's interest when he talked about feeling your pain. What was that all about?
Oh, yes. Well, let's see if I can do Bill Clinton while sick. I feel your pain. I gotta tell you, no one has more sympathy than me. You can come over here and you can put your head on my chest and you can cry your eyes out and I will sympathize and empathize with you. Or better yet, I can put my head on your chest, I can motorboat you, and then I can feel your sympathy that way too.
Well, Sheng Thao had a I feel your pain moment, but it went a little differently.
But today we are facing one of the most challenging moments in our city's history. Many Oaklanders are hurting right now. You may be frightened, and I know how you feel.
Is that so?
We might have our first Sheng Thao drop right here.
You may be frightened, and I know how you feel.
And why is that?
Well, I think we know why.
It's Wild Wild West out here.
There's enough crime to spread around to everyone in the city of Oakland.
You may be frightened, and I know how you feel. My family have also been victims of crime. I've had my car broken into, and I too felt angry.
I think she realized that trying to sell it as bipping just hasn't worked out lately.
No, you got to spell it out.
I've had my car broken into, and I too felt angry. I've had my house broken into while my son was home, and I too felt scared.
But you still fired the police chief for no reason.
Now, politicians like to list things in three. What else happened to this woman?
You may be struggling to meet ends meet, and I get it.
Well, there's no place left to work because crime has run everyone out of town that owns a business.
I have faced many of the same struggles throughout much of the majority of my life. And at the top of this address, I want to say very clearly that community safety remains and is my top priority as your mayor.
Wait, is she saying that community safety was also her priority for the last 10 months, including when she fired the police chief and burglaries and robberies are up 50% under her tenure?
Well, if this is the best she can do, their goose is cooked.
Here's something we can all agree with. Sheng Thao says the crime wave in Oakland is unacceptable.
And that the surge in crime and violence we are seeing on our streets is unacceptable. And I'm going to say that again. The surge in crime and violence that we are seeing in our streets is totally and completely unacceptable.
It's like totally unacceptable.
Oh, no, it's very acceptable. Very, very, very acceptable.
We've been accepting it for quite some time. She turned into Ferrer for a second.
The evidence is like crystal clear on that.
In this State of the City address, I will discuss plans for homelessness, housing, and the many other critical issues facing our city. But it is important that, to me that we start with public safety. And after 10 months in office, I can tell you that this job is certainly humbling.
That's as close as we're going to get to an admission of failure, huh?
Not a day goes by where I don't wish I could just wave a magic wand and silence the gunfire.
Oh, there is another drop that's going on the wall for Mayor Sheng Thao. So far we've got this classic.
You may be frightened, and I know how you feel. Not a day goes by where I don't wish I could just wave a magic wand and silence the gunfire.
That may make an appearance on every single crime blotter involving Oakland.
Bring comfort and healing to every family who has been impacted by violence. And give every person who sees a life of crime as the only option a different path.
Wait, what?
She's offering different paths to people who see a life of crime as their only option?
Well, so she's only just starting to make the pivot from we need alternatives to incarceration. We need to fire the police chief. We don't need police. Pam Price is doing a great job. She's just slowly starting to realize that that kind of political power is unsustainable and she's not going to be around much longer. This is what London Breed was doing when she was just tiptoeing around trying to be tougher on crime. Do you remember when London Breed said this to the people breaking into cars?
You don't have to do this.
I do remember that quite distinctly.
You don't have to break into cars. There are plenty of jobs available in the city.
You could be a bus driver.
So Sheng Tao's not there yet. She's not at this level yet.
And less tolerant of all the bull that has destroyed our city.
So she truly believes all the people that are robbing and burglarizing and murdering in Oakland, they did not choose that life. There were just no options for them.
And give every person who sees a life of crime as the only option a different path.
That's right. You know, I'm thinking about going to cosmetology school, or I'm thinking about robbing a Supercuts. As far as I'm concerned, the only option I have is to rob the Supercuts. So let's go steal a car and drive it through the front door at 2 a.m.
Well, maybe if Oakland had more after-school programs, and then kids would be set on the right path. They'd realize that there is paths to success. Imagine if you had, like, a youth basketball league. Oh, wait.
Oh, my God. They melted the basketball court.
Well, could you play in a hole or crater?
I mean, and literally, just a few weeks ago, we told you the story of the youth football league that had to leave town because there was a gunfight between gang members on the field.
Well, where was that magic wand?
Now, for your consideration, is yet another Sheng Thao bucket full of cliches.
And I know we have work to do, but we can only do it if we all come together as one Oakland.
That means nothing.
No.
She can talk about coming together as much as she wants, even more than the Rolling Stones. It means absolutely nothing.
No, the only place Oakland is coming together is in the emergency room.
Sheng Thao does say she wants more police, which is a funny thing to say when there is still no police chief for the last 10 months.
But she fired.
There is something about the...
She fired, and an independent investigation found the reason that she fired him over was BS.
There is something about the recent spike of crime that feels a little different. And in many ways it is. We know that the sharp increase in property crimes and auto burglaries are tied to organized groups with sophisticated tactics and networks. These organized criminal enterprises are coordinating operations regionally. And it's
she is not ready for prime time.
No, she's not. But that doesn't mean that they won't nominate her.
And a small group of people are causing the most harm in our communities. In Oakland, we must adapt to our police intervention with more intelligence, with more technology, and with more highly trained and responsive officers. That's why I'm committed to increasing the number of police officers on our streets, with a strong preference for diverse, homegrown officers who know our community and our people.
Yeah, they're not taking you up on that.
No. What is the signing bonus up in Oakland right now?
$70,000.
Yeah, none of them want to work for you.
It's why my budget this year funded 6 new police academies.
Why would you want to work in a city where the mayor threw the police chief under the bus the second she got into office as some kind of, like, kick someone's ass the first day in prison motto?
And the pirates have literally taken over the marina.
And there's one cop who knows how to operate the police boat.
And I personally directed the interim chief of police to take measures to improve the graduation rates from our police academies. And to
Wait a second. How many people are failing the police academies?
Wait. So we're going to push them across the finish line at the police academy if they can't pass? Isn't that where we find out if they can do things like shoot correctly?
Yeah, they'll learn it on-the-job training.
Okay. Here's what I want you to do. I want to practice your shooting skills by taking a look at that prototype way over there of the guy robbing the bank. Here's the gun. It's loaded. Ready, aim, fire. I'm sorry, sir. You're not going to pass this portion of the test because you missed the suspect, but you did shoot up that school bus filled with children.
And to intensify our focus on hiring. It is why we brought back our police foot patrols in key hotspots earlier this year. And it is why, and I am also pleased to actually announce that we recently expanded them citywide from 6 foot patrol officers to 12.
That's it?
That's a big city.
Now, John, you know how these state of the cities go. Typically, a mayor tries to highlight all of the big things they've accomplished in their first year and all the things they're going to do going forward. Well, Sheng Thao's in a unique situation where most of the accomplishments that she's had are not ones you'd want to highlight. Crime is through the roof, both violent crime and property crime. Police officers are resigning left and right. The Oakland A's don't want to be in Oakland anymore. So she had to try to find something, some kind of silver lining, something positive that has happened since Sheng Thao was elected mayor in the city of Oakland. And this is all she could find.
And due to Oakland's increase in investment, we are on pace right now to double the number of abandoned, burned out, and blighted vehicles removed from our streets in Oakland.
Okay.
That's the accomplishment.
If what they're doing is better than any other city, is they're moving more cars off the streets that were stolen and set on fire, then you still have a large number of cars that have been stolen and set on fire.
Well, there's nothing they can do about cars getting stolen. There's definitely nothing they can do about cars getting stolen and then set on fire. But if you're in the city of Oakland and you park and burn up a car, don't you worry, we're going to tow it.
And due to Oakland's increase in investment, we are on pace right now to double the number of abandoned, burned out, and blighted vehicles removed from our streets in Oakland.
You notice she didn't say putting out the fire. I think they just let it burn out, and then once it's just nothing but ashes and car bones, they come and remove it.
Well, then it's easier to tow.
Well, I don't even know how you tow that out.
That's the one thing she's good at, John. The one thing they've done that's been an improvement over the prior administration, which is saying something, that things could get this worse than when Libby Schaff was in charge.
Well, at least they're on top of something.
Come together right now over me.
It's 2:30 on the John Phillips Show, Talk Radio 790 KABC. Randy, you did something I did earlier this week.
That's right. Jeff writes in at johnnydontlikeshow@gmail.com, and the subject line is "Come Together." Actually was the Beatles. It wasn't the Stones, and it wasn't Three Dog Night. I made a reference to Come Together because of what Mayor Sheng Thao happened to say in one of her buckets full of cliches. Oh, let me turn off the Beatles real quick here. This is what she had to say.
Here in Oakland, we know that coming together is how we will tackle our collective challenges.
And I wrongly said that that song was the Rolling Stones. And the second I said it, I knew it was wrong, but I thought I'd get away with it. But Jeff held me accountable.
That's right, because accountability is what we do here.
That's right, Gavin, isn't it?
I mean, it's not just about money. It's about damn accountability.
And, of course, if you'd like to email the show, you can do so at johnnydontlikeshow@gmail.com. That's johnnydontlikeshow@gmail.com. And, Randy, we're getting a lot of email about last hour's show, our interview with Eric Siddall, candidate for DA. If you missed it, you may want to go back and listen to the podcast.
That's right. You can listen to it. It's posted now, KABC.com. Click on podcasts or go to the Apple Podcast app, iHeart, Spotify, search for The John Phillips Show, hit subscribe. You can download all the episodes. Or the easiest way, get the KABC app, search KABC AM in the Apple App Store or the Android Store. Best, most clutter-free way to listen to the live stream wherever you are in case you're outside of a place where you can get the AM signal, and the best place to listen to podcasts of this show. You can download it right now. Check out that interview with Eric Siddall and tell us your thoughts at johnnydontlikeshow@gmail.com.
It's Woo Wednesday.
Ric Flair.
It's Woo Wednesday. Yeah, baby. Woo, 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 woo.
Which means, Randy, tomorrow is Throwback Thursday.
And I got to say, I think we're doing it emails from now on because we got so many fantastic suggestions. And unfortunately, we can only pick one. There are some that I'd love to do, but I think this one is going to be the winner. It comes from Bev, who writes in at johnnydontlikeshow@gmail.com. I was touched by John's tribute on Monday to Suzanne Summers. Learning about her love and concerns for California, I want to suggest songs about California towns towns and cities like San Francisco, Weezer's Beverly Hills, Do You Know the Way to San Jose, I Love LA, etc. Thanks, and I love your show. That comes from Bev, and I think that is going to be our theme for Throwback Thursday in honor of Suzanne Summers, who loved California. Songs about cities and towns in California.
I love the idea, and I love the tribute to Suzanne Summers, who definitely deserves it. In the meantime, Randy, what do you say we make a couple of listeners very happy?
Well, let's do that right now. 790 KABC welcomes Madonna, the Celebration Tour at the Kia Forum on March 7, 2024. Tickets are on sale now at Ticketmaster.com, but right now, caller number 9 at 1-888-790-5222 gets a pair of tickets to the show. Tickets furnished by Live Nation. Good luck dialing.
Wait, who are these tickets for?
Madonna.
You know, I was just thinking not long ago, Randy, my favorite Madonna movie of all time is A League of Their Own. You ever see that one?
It's a fantastic movie. It's a classic.
Oh, yeah. In that movie, Madonna, which this movie is about an all-girls baseball team, Madonna was the center fielder. Gina Davis was the catcher. Tom Hanks was the manager. And here's a trivia question for you, Randy. Do you remember which position Rosie O'Donnell played?
Which one was that?
She played the backstop. We're going through the sound of Oakland Mayor Sheng Thao, State of the City.
How am I supposed to respond to this email of the guy that wants my top 50 drops?
No.
I mean, I like to fulfill requests, but I don't know if I can think of the top 50. Although I think this would be in the top 50.
Not a day goes by where I don't wish I could just wave a magic wand and silence the gunfire.
She is special. So when we last left Sheng Thao, she was telling us about Oakland's number one accomplishment since she's taken over for mayor.
And due to Oakland's increase in investment, we are on pace right now to double the number of abandoned, burned out, and blighted vehicles removed from our streets in Oakland.
We're number one. We're number one.
We can't do anything about the cars getting set on fire, but we'll make sure you don't have to look at them for more than a couple of days. Now, Sheng Thao did talk about how she wants to hire more police officers, but that's not all she wants to do.
Today, we now have more officers on the street than we have had at any time over the last 2 years. And we must and we will do more. In the next few months, you will see new community ambassadors in some of the busiest business corridors throughout the city.
Uh-oh.
They're just going to get stabbed.
Have you not seen what's going on in your sister city?
People have been stabbed in Urban Alchemy. They've been shot. They've been attacked. And they still show up every single day as an alternative to policing for this community.
In the next few months, you will see new community ambassadors in some of the busiest business corridors throughout the city. You'll see new security personnel, security cameras, and other additional infrastructure will also be in place to enhance public safety just in time for the holidays.
Boy, if there was foreshadowing for chaos in the future, I don't know how you could have written it any better than that.
Hey, Sheng Thao, are the ambassadors going to be getting stabbed this holiday season?
Yes, they do. Yes, they do.
Well, now, at least she's honest.
Now, of course, the other huge problem plaguing Oakland is Oakland has a 911 system that doesn't work. Is she going to do something about that?
In the next year, 911 response times will improve.
What number?
Well, maybe that's the problem. If they don't give the number out accurately, people can't get a hold of them.
In the next year, 911 response times...
Just 9-1. Because by the time you hit the other one, you already got shot.
In the next year, 911 response times will improve significantly. We are recruiting new dispatchers, taking the deliberate steps to retain veteran dispatchers, and replacing our antiquated computer-aided dispatch system. And we will not stop making progress until we fully fix 911.
Good luck with that.
Okay, so just to put this in context, Oakland is a city where 911 goes down all the time.
That's right.
You call 911, and it's not like you have to wait on hold for a long time. you just get a busy signal for days on end.
It has been up to 15 minutes, if it's working at all, to even get someone to answer, let alone if they have someone to send out to you, which they don't.
And if it goes down on a holiday weekend when you have lots of shootings and you have lots of people who are meeting with their family and maybe injuring themselves, whatever the case may be, you're visiting a relative, you fall down some stairs, you need an ambulance, guess what? No help from 911 because it's not working.
Now, this State of the City from Sheng Thao had something for everybody, including all the people that want more policing. I got something for you. The people that want alternatives to policing, I got something for you, too.
While we commit to having a robust police department, my administration is also, we are also committed to alternative responses to prevent violence. My budget expands investment for the Mobile Assistance Community Responders of Oakland program, also known as MACRO. And MACRO deploys highly trained EMTs and community intervention specialists instead of armed officers to respond to nonviolent, non-emergent quality of life calls across the whole city.
You know what MACRO is short for?
What's that?
MACRO aggression.
You know what? And after those MACRO workers, they finally get attacked by the people they're supposed to help because they're unarmed and they can't arrest people. Sheng Tao's going to tell them this.
You may be frightened, and I know how you feel.
And finally, something that I'm pretty okay with. Sheng Thao takes complete ownership over the most embarrassing blunder Oakland's had all year, failing to file the paperwork on time to get the grant money to go after retail crime.
I want to update you on something that needs fixing. We missed an opportunity with the retail theft grant. And as mayor, I own that. And the buck stops with me. So let me tell you what we are doing moving forward. We are fast-tracking the hiring of a grants coordinator. We are bringing in additional grant management expertise. And we are upgrading and modernizing the city's grant management software tools.
It was literally a form they had to fill out that they didn't fill out. A form, like you do at the doctor's office every time you go, like you do every time you update your passport or your global entry. It is a form that you fill out on the computer.
That's the mayor of Oakland, everybody.
Randy, what do you say we end the show today by making a couple of listeners very happy?
Well, let's do that right now. 790 KABC welcomes The Nightmare Before Christmas in concert at the Hollywood Bowl on October 29th. Tickets are on sale now at Ticketmaster.com. But right now, caller number 9 at 1-888-790-5222 gets a pair of tickets to the show. Tickets furnished by Live Nation. Good luck dialing.
And, Randy, we've received a request for a combination of drops mashed up together.
Okay, what would you like?
Oh, let's see. How about Caught Me With My Pants Down, followed by I Take Things On Both Ends, followed by My Pants Are Now Up.
Yeah, I can do that.
Caught Me With My Pants Down. And
I Receive Things On Both Ends.
My Pants Are Now Up.
Well, you did suspect that those drops would come in handy at some point.
It's funny because you had someone text you about that, and someone also emailed us asking for the exact same thing.
Great minds think alike. And Randy, tomorrow's Throwback Thursday, and it's going to be our tribute to Suzanne Summers.
Since Suzanne Summers loved California and cared so much about California, songs about California, the state, cities, towns, whatever you got, email us your song suggestions at johnnydontlikeshow@gmail.com. That's johnnydontlikeshow@gmail.com.
See y'all tomorrow.